fight such that no life is witnessed, no heart but detected. In this way the beast can remain for an age as knowledge passes and pursues leap out their lives. Scribbled in the corner. I was wrong, no gentleman. Hunters didn't kill it. It allowed this. Keep the pieces apart, I guess. Away from the heart.
Okay.
I will not fall back!
How did I end up there? I have no idea.
It will be done.
Perhaps I could have a try at that.
Of course.
I thought I was on the other side of the roads. That's pretty damn sure. I will have to go back a lot. This is the very fucking beginning. Holy shit. I went full circle. Go to the Crosscut Drifter's cache. And then I will randomize and move on. This party is capable, but it's not. Not really the best I have, not yet the third best I have. Yeah, these are the reserves of the reserves. The people you only call when you're desperate enough that your best troops are re-engaged. Let me see if this path opens anything.
That's not.
At least I won't have to backtrack from further deep in the deep roads. interplanetary space. Thorn of the Dead Goods. Efforts Gloves. Ring of the Warrior.
Really good thing.
In the moment that it struck, the blade of the Grey Warden who killed Toth, Archdemon of Fire, shattered into three pieces. After the other of hunters fell, the wardens carried their fallen brother to Weishaupt for a hero's burial, but the broken pieces of his sword were left behind. For years, the shards lay forgotten in the battlefield, still became etched with the corrupted blood of the dead god. They were eventually discovered by a Navarran woman searching among the bones for a sign of her lost son. She sold them to a blacksmith, not knowing what they truly were, for 10 bits. The smith, however, knew that he had purchased more than scrap metal and fashioned the shards into three identical daggers, the thorns of the dead gods. They left his hands and were scattered to the far corners of Thedas, but everywhere they went, the thorns left misery and loss in their wake. The woman who unearthed them died soon after the plague. The smith fell into his forge. Each person who has held one of the thorns, even briefly, has died an untimely death.
Okay.
Go on then.
I guess you are going to die an untimely death.
Or maybe not. Three damage. I don't think it's better. It does more damage, yes. But I'm losing 2 dexterity, which is very important for a fucker like this. Okay, let's see if this one does open up a new path. Yes, it did. Ortensteig. Okay, let's randomize the party.
Braska!
Braska! One, two, 9, 4, that says 10, 6, that's Alistair, yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, please let it be a mage. Well, that, I guess that's good as well. All right. One, four,
yes.
Six.
Yes.
All warriors, but, well, you cannot have everything you want, can you? Warriors and me, I guess it will have to do. At least I'm a spirit healer now. Okay, I need to get his tactics in order. Absorbing lingering enemy of all nearby corpses. This is basically a free heal, okay. Focuses the real on setting countenance into a weapon, making a target cower in fear for 10 seconds unless it passes a mental resistance check. Increases the effectiveness of taunt and threat. Okay. Radiating an aura of psychic pain, the river inflicts constant spirit damage to nearby creatures. The river also suffers damage as well as an additional health regeneration penalty. Okay. Driven by pain, the river gains larger bonuses to damage wherever health decreases. Because this mode also incurs a penalty in health regeneration, the river flirts with death the longer the frenzy persists. Let me take a look at Ogryn. Berserker. The stench of blood and death drives the berserker into a willing fury, providing bonus to damage and mental resistance while reducing stamina regeneration. Constraint reduces stamina regeneration penalty and resilience adds a bonus to health regeneration. Gains a bonus to health regeneration. Final blow. I like this much more because it's a lot of passives and two sustains. And one sustained and one activated. That's much more manageable than the other one. All the berserker stamina goes into a single swing. If the bow connects, the attack inflicts extra damage. That sounds very much like this one. Pretty sure there is one very similar around here. Maybe I'm mistaken. Maybe it's another one. Okay. Yeah, Berserker. I'm going to wait until I can unlock Berserker. Because Champion... Well, Champion is similar. Power and cunning, and this one is the strength. Yeah. Let's wait. Ah! Okay. Fuck. I guess I will have to take champion. Because I don't want any of this. Any of these two. Champion it is. Let me check. No, Sten is maxed out on behavior. No, Grunt has everything. It's not what I would have liked, but whatever. Sometimes that's how it goes. Knockdown.
As you wish.
As you wish. As you wish. What about you, Alistair? Altair? Do I want anything for you? That sounds useful enough. Let's not give him a second specialization. Now, I've changed my mind. How long ago did I save? I have no idea. Did I save just here? Free heal is too big of a deal for me to ignore it.
Braska!
Yes, yes.
Yeah, let's go with River. It's a free heal of 40 plus, that's too much to ignore. In a big fight that can save me. Yeah.
Good on.
So, Alistair will also get this one. Free heal is too useful to ignore. Yeah, that should work out fairly well. See if it's 10. Okay, let's go with Ogryn. And let's see. This is going to take a while. Does he have the warrior? The two-handed line. So I should more or less copy what Sten has. Why not? Let's copy Sten's tactics for Ogryn. Enemy at your range, pommel strike. Enemy health. Below 60 mighty blow, below 40 critical, below 20 sunder. 60, 40, 20 mighty critical sunder. Enemy health below 60. Mighty. No, it's critical. Below 20. Mighty critical sunder. Mighty critical. Thank you. Okay. I think threaten at 30, 20, yeah, 20 stamina should be the last one. There you have it, we have him set up. Time to move forward. Maybe check if any of the things I got are useful for them. The Ring of the Warrior. Well, that will work for him. He has nothing.